In this video, we will sew a simple skirt in CLO 3D. I will share with you some tips and tricks on how to sew this gathered skirt quick and easy step by step. These include using some basic tool in CLO 3D, such as a segment sewing tool, an added sewing tool, and more. Then apply the fabrics as well as the top stitches to give a finished look. So for this video, I'm going to share with you some tip on how to sew this garter skirt in CLO 3D step by step. Okay, so as you can see right here, we have 6 pieces of pattern. And when we first place this pattern into CLO, over here in this object browser, we have one fabric. That fabric, by default, anytime we bring any pattern into CLO, will drop in into the default fabrics, okay? All right, so back to the pattern pieces. We have facings up here, and we have waistband, and we have skirt front and skirt back. First thing we want to do here, we are going to delete this facing, okay? To do that, I'm going to come over here to the transform pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to come over here and my key selects this facing right there. And then I'm going to press down the delete or backspace on the keyboard to delete them. Now we have left ours. Waistband front, waistband back, and front skirt and back skirt patterns. Okay, I'm going to pan it a little bit to the left by pressing down Option All and left click. All right, next I'm going to load the avatar into this 3D workspace. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this library tab, then come down here to this avatar folder, double click on it to open. After that, I'm going to come down here to this asset tab. First of all, let me expand that tab a little bit by just hover the mouse over here, and you see this two-headed arrow pop up. I'm going to just left click and then expand it to the right. Okay, then I'm going to double click on this female underscore video. So I'm going to select default avatar right here, FV2 underscore Camilla. To load the avatar into the workspace, I'm going to double click on the avatar, just like that. Okay, so now the avatar is loaded to the workspace, as well as you can see the silhouette of the avatar in this 2D window. After that, I'm going to zoom out a little bit in this 2D window. Then I'm going to, once again, my key selects all that pattern pieces, and then left click and then drag it to above the avatar. Okay. Then I want to do the same right here in this 3D window. I can either click and then drag like that because those pattern pieces are selected, or I can come over here to the t-shirt icon looking thing. That icon is a reset 2D all for pattern. So I can click on that and then reset to the same exact pattern layout as in the 2D window. Okay. Next, I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Okay. I'm going to once again pan it back to the right just a little bit. And I'm going to do the same right here in this 3D window. Press down Option All on the keyboard, left click to pan. Okay. Before we sew the skirt, we are going to place these pattern pieces onto the avatar. To do that, I'm going to come over here to the 3D menu And I'm going to come to this avatar icon, and we want to select show arrangement point. Click on it to select. Then we have this arrangement point appear on the avatar. After that, I'm going to come over here to this 2D window. And as you can see right here, this blue highlighted appear on that transform pattern tool, which means that tool is active. So I'm going to marquee select all these front pattern pieces from the waistband as well as the skirt front. Then I'm going to come over here to this 3D window and hover my mouse over that avatar. And as we can see, the silhouette appear on the avatar. I'm going to left click to place that pattern. Next, while that pattern are selected, I'm going to come over here to the property editor. Then click on the slider to scroll it down to the arrangement. And then right here, right to the offset, I'm going to click on that slider and then slide it to the right to expand the pattern. Okay, just like that. Next, I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Next, we're going to place the back pattern pieces onto the avatar. To do that, I can either press down Command or Control, right click and rotate her, just like that, or I can press on number 8 on the keyboard to see the back view of this avatar. After that, I'm going to come over here and marquee select all these pattern pieces, excuse me, this waistband as well as the skirt back pattern pieces. Then come back over here and hover the mouse over the avatar. After that, I'm going to left click to place that pattern pieces. And as you can see, the pattern are kind of curved onto the avatar and we want to expand that. So to do that, I'm going to once again come to the property editor and click on that slider and come down here to this offset function, and I'm going to click on that slider once again and slide it to the right to expand that pattern. After that, I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Okay, next I'm going to press on number 2 to see the front view of the avatar. Then I'm going to hide this arrangement point. I can either come over here and hover the mouse over the avatar and select that second icon there, or I can press down shift plus little F to hide the arrangement point. Then I'm going to kind of rotate her a little bit, press down command or control, right click and then drag to the left to rotate her to the left, to the right to rotate her to the right. So there you have it, Designista. I hope you find this video helps. And remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Thank you.